MC Patrick Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs taking on Mac Jones and the New England Patriots.
From one of the loudest venues in the NFL, there's a look at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the stadium tunnels, and the noise level in this place was just about off the charts. They are set for football as the Chiefs get set to do battle with the New England Patriots. Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Kansas City. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. So here come the Patriots getting ready on offense. They'll be led by the Heisman finalist from a season ago, the rookie from Alabama, Mac Jones.
Mac Jones absolutely believed in himself coming out of high school. Went to Alabama despite the fact there are many high-profile quarterbacks already on the roster and blossomed into a Heisman Trophy candidate in his final season with 41 touchdowns and only 4 interceptions. Steady, consistent as a passer, doesn't have the biggest cannon for an arm, but can stretch the field and lay those passes in on the deep ball.
Now Jones, and his first look is incomplete.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Jones. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Well, for teams that like to play man coverage, running corner routes can be tough on them because of the ability of getting into it. Sometimes you're squaring it off. Sometimes you're just rounding it. Sometimes there's a fake. Sometimes there's not. That makes it very, very difficult for a DB to stay with it.
Throwing Jones. He'll let this go deep for Bourne. And it'll be incomplete. Good job staying with him defensively. And it'll bring up 2nd down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside. And my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Second and 10. They'll run with a former member of the Crimson Tide, Damian Harris. And the Chiefs D closes in on him again, and they drop him behind the line. It'll go as a loss of 1 yard, so now they deal with 3rd and 11. It's probably a pretty good sign here on the opening drive if your guys from the secondary are coming up and spilling things in the backfield.
How about the adrenaline and aggressiveness that led his eyes to the backfield to run up there and make that tackle, setting a tone early for his defense.
Now on 3rd down, an extra DB out there for the Chiefs. Looking to throw, Jones. Harris has it over the middle. And he can only get this to the 42-yard line, and that is not near enough. Only 2 yards, and it'll be a punt on their opening possession, and they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area that they want him involved. Just as you said, they want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
The Patriots send out their punter. As the first drive of the game stalls out, he's on to punt. They call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. The KC offense set to go, led as always by the gunslinger, a former MVP in this league. It's Patrick Mahomes.
And simply put, for many, he's the gold standard for quarterbacks in today's NFL because of his ability to create, find the open man, use all the different arm angles that he has. He's a complete package, and boy, his team loves to play around him.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 16. They'll run for the first time with Clyde Edwards-Helaire. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game. Trying to establish the inside run. Run with toughness now. Hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Second down, back to Edwards-Helaire. And he'll get only a couple up to the 22.
Not the kind of game that we'll go absolutely crazy for, but it's the kind of game that you need to have when you're running back in the NFL. And Clyde Edwards-Helaire, with that low center of gravity and strength, he's going to get those tough, gritty yards for you when necessary.
Throwing now is Mahomes. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. And he'll be corralled right around the 34.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw. And they hooked up there for a first down.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Working from the gun, Mahomes. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45.
Well, from their point of view, this game could not be starting out much better, could it? Force a punt on defense, and now they're moving it crisply on offense.
Crisply, I like that.
Like
yeah,
that?
Well, yeah, moving it very, very well. Looks like the defense on their heels a little bit. You put a score in here, long way to go, but you're right, that's a heck of a start.
Yeah, and I think this is where the play caller is looking at his play sheet and saying, do I have that dagger play? Do I have that play and just finish them off right now? Because I think they'd love to gain that big advantage early.
On first down, Mahomes. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
I spotted man coverage on the outside. I expect we'll see a lot of that from this defense as this game moves on. And that was a good job there as that one was knocked away.
Here's second and 10. Mahomes to throw once more. It's Kelce on the ground. And to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it. And he will have a Chiefs first down by about a yard as they're able to convert on 3rd and 2.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been 4-down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
Thank you. first and 10. Here's Mahomes. Gets this one to Hill. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Edwards-Helaire as they run out of the gun.
And just a couple yards there down to the 17.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
So first and goal now from the 7-yard line. Mahomes going to throw. Try to find his tight end, Kelce, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Dante Hightower. And the Pats are going to take over at their own 11-yard line.
Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points no matter what. At worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting three. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Throwing to start the drive, Jones. Open man is Myers. And he'll be out of bounds right around the 20. They'll come up now on second and a yard. Now after that last running play, we've got an offensive lineman down on the field. We'll step aside and get an update when we return to KC. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. Well, after an interception, last thing you want to do is go three and out, give the ball right back. They avoided that.
Yeah, you definitely do not want to do that. I remember in college I played with a really big-time player on defense. We ended up getting an interception as we passed the offense coming out. He told him, if you don't take care of this football, you'll have to answer to me later. You definitely want to take care of it, pick up first downs.
Here's Jones. on first down. Open man is Kendrick Bourne. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
On second down, this is Harris. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
On third down, here's Harris.
Quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. From the gun, Jones. The connection here with Nelson Agholor. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for 2nd down, staying ahead of schedule. And he'll get it down to the 47 here.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
So now 1st and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 47. A give to Harris. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, 2nd down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Back to throw. Jones. And that's incomplete.
Well, to me, there is no question about the intent there, and I think he was a little fortunate that the penalty flag didn't come out for grounding. But he'll get away with it and get another shot on 3rd down.
And the line to gain here is the 37 on 3rd down. Looking to throw, Jones. Hunter Henry brings it in. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
Well, the coverage was tight that time. They allowed the pass underneath to him, but they rallied to him pretty fast, too. Converged on him and got him down. That'll bring up 4th down.
Field goal would have been a decent length at 55 yards. They keep the kicking unit on the sideline. They're going for it. They're going for it. This is Harris. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he's short of the line to gain. The Patriots come up empty on 4th down. And the Chiefs defense comes up with a stop. Even though they didn't get it, probably the right call. Too long for a field goal and just not a whole lot to gain from a punt there.
Yeah, you wouldn't have really netted very much yardage if you punt the ball, right? And the thing about a field goal, and you know this from so much experience, the longer the field goal, the lower it comes out off the kick, right? Which means it's got a better chance of being blocked. So you're taking a chance either way. I like the fact they went for it.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 37. Here's Edwards-Helaire as they will start on the ground. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
We're scoreless after one. Second quarter from Arrowhead. It's the Chiefs in possession as they've got a second and eight forthcoming. Set up the screen to Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
I like the play design there. They occupied the defense downfield, everyone trying to account for someone. But unfortunately, they didn't account for the running back slipping out of the backfield. And he was absolutely unnoticed and wound up getting big yards on that play.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. And incomplete on the deep ball.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now here's Mahomes. That one complete to Hill. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
People worry about throwing the out route because often it can get jumped, and that can turn into an either an incompletion or an interception. But not on that one. Everything came together, and he catches it and goes over the sideline.
Mahomes now to throw. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
Too long for a field goal, too short to punt, that in-between range, and they'll go for it on fourth down. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. He is going to find Hill here. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. From the gun, it's Mahomes. Now a swing pass, it's Edwards-Helaire. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Second down at 7. To throw, it's Mahomes. Complete, the tight end, Kelsey. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 14.
He's certainly done a nice job spreading the field on this drive, and here he finds his big tight end for good yardage. And that's what you have to do. Keep defenses guessing about where you're going to go with the football.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Not today.
They'll run. It's Edwards-Helaire. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
From the 9, second and 5. Here's Mahomes to throw. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, he's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
They'll break the huddle and come up on the 9th play of this drive, needing 5 yards on third down. Looking to throw is Mahomes. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
Butker's kick here is good. And the Chiefs are out to a 3-0 lead. So they wind up turning the turnover into points as they convert there for 3.
Yeah, that was a nice job there to force the fumble. They recover, hand things over to their offense, and then the offense went down and got them 3. That alone, that's not enough to win a game, but both units able to do their jobs on these last 2 drives.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. This fielded right at the goal line. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. New England's offense set to go.
They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a 4th down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went 4 and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. There was a little space there, yes, but that was a well-executed run by the rookie.
It was, and he wasn't one of the higher-rated rookie running backs coming out. He was probably on the next tier. But let me tell you something. If he becomes more consistent and continues to have that drive to be one of the best, we'll see more of that in the future.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Now it's Stevenson. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Throwing on 2nd down. Jones, that's complete into the hands of Myers. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a 1st down.
Now a 1st down carry for Harris. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. They'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. They hand this off to Harris. And he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory. 8 yards on the ground there, and now they're looking at a 3rd and 2.
But you've got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a 2nd and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to 3rd and manageable with that run.
New England on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. Back to throw. Jones. Open man is Jacoby Myers. He's got it. And he will have a Patriots 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
I like the call on 3rd and 2. They were geared up to stop the run. I like the fact they just hit him quick. A little slant route. All about timing there, partner.
Yeah, the timing, everything well executed. Jones now on 1st and 10. This one to Bourne out on the left side. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage. And that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area. So you make curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. Jones throwing on 1st down, and that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's 2nd down.
He was trying to get that one out to his running back out of the backfield, but that one was read and timed perfectly, and they were able to break it up.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Back to throw again. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Henry. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the 1st down.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's 2nd down.
My first thought is surprise because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
So they'll come up after the incompletion for 2nd down. They'll look to throw again. Got the connection here to Bourne. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
New England on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. They're up against a 3rd and 1 situation. And that's going to be caught for a Patriot touchdown. Kendrick Bourne there to make the grab. And the Patriots have taken the lead. There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron. Had some heat on that bad boy. Sometimes you throw a touchdown pass, and sometimes
you throw, what, a touchdown strike?
There you go. That's my man in concert.
Nick Folk for the point after. Man, this is up and good to make it 7-3. So that drive, 12 plays in length, and it's finished off by a Pats touchdown. kick it away after the touchdown.
From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
The Chiefs offense now making their way back onto the field. It's been very much a slow start for them. Three drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is one. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 26. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. They'll drop to throw. That's caught. It's DeMarcus Robinson. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll step aside and get an update when we return to Arrowhead. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Back to throw. Caught, Kelce, left side. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
From the 41, Mahomes got his man complete over the middle. It's Hill. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 44-yard line. Had to put that ball in there with a little extra zip, but he put it right where it needed to be.
Yeah, and that little extra pace that he had on the pass, that required a little extra concentration for him, didn't it? Ball can get on you pretty quick in that manner, and he handled it well and picked up the first down.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Hill. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
First and 10, it's Edwards-Helaire with it. Ooh, with a juke. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. 40 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
Some big plays in the passing game on this drive. And here's one out of the running game. So the passing game loosening things up. Now there's room to roam.
First half, 7-3, our score. Mahomes now on first down. Completes it to Hardman. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
From the 16, Mahomes, middle of the field, it's Robinson. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
This has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
So it's first and goal, and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. Now back to throw. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. Marching in for the sack, Matthew Judon.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation, because the silver lining, it took a sack on first and goal. But that close to the goal line, that still definitely hurts.
So they've been in the red zone 3 times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on second and goal?
Mahomes' throw into the hands here of Hardman.
The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Looking to throw. Steps away to his left. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. The offense is staying out there. Here we go on fourth and goal from the 1. They'll go. It's Edwards-Helaire. And he didn't get there. Knocked backwards to the 2-yard line. They stop him up short on fourth and goal from the 1. And the Patriots get the football back. Here comes Mac Jones and the rest of the Patriot offense. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number 2 here in the second quarter. They'll start the drive with Harris. And he'll get this up past the 5 to the 7-yard line. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts, as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number 1. After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5. Looking to throw, Jones. And he's going to go down right near the goal line. The officials look at each other. They're going to mark him at the 1-yard line. After the sack, they'll come up now 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
And indeed, that's what they'll do, as they run it here. And they'll indeed stop him on 3rd down. And now what do you want to do with your timeouts? The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. the Patriots send out their punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. And he's able to get it out quickly, and this is not a bad kick here. Nifty move. They'll call it a punt of 44 yards. The return was for 7. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50, first and 10.
The Chiefs going to go back on offense one final time in this first half. And we'll see how aggressive they want to be in these final stages before the half.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. From midfield, here's Mahomes. And that is incomplete.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. He'll look to throw. That's caught left side by Hardman. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get 3 before halftime. This officially a 55-yard attempt. So at halftime, it's the Patriots with the advantage. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome everyone to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far, and certainly plenty to look forward to as the teams are right back out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. Chiefs football to begin quarter number 3, and they trail here as we are back underway now on EA Sports. And this will not be returned, so the second half begins with a touchback. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number 3. They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Second half starts with a run by Edwards-Helaire. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. A shotgun snap and a give to Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Back to throw here. He'll find his running back, Edwards-Helaire. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. Boy, how good has this defense been seemingly all game long?
I really think right from the first snap, I think you're really onto something there. In this passing game, it just can't get off the ground. And that play, it wound up losing yardage.
Second and 11 now. Throwing now is Mahomes. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. So the pitch and catch good for 11. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. So that was all you're looking for on a play like that. Get the first down and keep the drive moving.
Yeah, it just looked to me like he just said to himself, I've got this. I'll take it. I'll pick it up and let's keep moving. Get the first down, get a new set, and let's start over.
Edwards-Helaire, and he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. A gain of three, second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a three-yard gain.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Working from the gun, Mahomes. On the slant, he's got Hardman. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots' 31-yard line. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Now a carry for Edwards-Helaire. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
On second and seven, Mahomes. And he'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7.
I'll tell you what, this offense is playing a little bit of keep away right now. They've come out here in the third quarter, possessed the ball for quite a while, and they keep on converting. Nice pitch and catch there to set up the first and goal.
They're going to look to throw. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Mahomes hitting his favorite target, Travis Kelce, on the touchdown pass. And the Chiefs are going to jump back in front.
The tight end position has always been dangerous, especially in the red zone, short field. But now even more so because these tight ends aren't necessarily the tight ends of old. They're the rocked-up wide receivers who have a little bit more speed, way harder to cover than before.
Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. So the drive goes 75 yards, 10 plays, and it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. after the touchdown. Here's Butker on to kick it away. This taken in at the goal line. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24. Here comes the Patriots offensive unit. They'll have it first here to begin the third quarter. And they'll be working from behind now following the touchdown a moment ago on the opening drive of the half.
I think the guys right now, as they go out on offense, they're zeroing in on one big key. They don't have to do anything differently just because they're down on the scoreboard now. The intent, still the same in what they plan to do on offense.
Throwing Jones. It's caught by Aguilar. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Now Jones. He's got it complete to Aguilar. And he's brought down.
A couple of first downs right in succession, and this is an offense that could really use a good drive, and they're off to a fast start here.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. A run with Harris out of the shotgun, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Harris. And he'll take this close to a first down at the Chiefs 34. 43 yards on the ground for him so far.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
On third down, Harris. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
First down, Harris, and he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
From the 25 on second down, Jones completes it to Aguilar. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
I love the drive they're working on here because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They've moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively, but they better be prepared for some adjustments to come their way now.
Here's Stevenson. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Ramondre Stevenson taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Patriots have retaken the lead.
Hard to argue with that being their best drive of the game so far as they use the running game to get them into the end zone.
Couldn't agree more, partner. Prior to that drive, they sputtered a little bit, but it looks like they found the formula. I would expect them to go back to that more and more as this game develops.
Extra point up and good by Folk, and the lead is now 14-10. So that one, an 8-play drive, it spans 75 yards.
And it was polished off by a Ramondre Stevenson touchdown run.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown.
Taken at the goal line. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
Patrick Mahomes on his way out for their next drive. 5 for 5 that last drive. Touchdown pass as well. He was clicking. Receivers, I don't want to be cliche, but running really solid routes too.
And what I love about it is when you look across any team, all right, the body types of the receivers are usually different. The way that they get open, different as well. Some of them use power to get open. Some of them use those head fakes and subtle moves. Some of them just use pure speed. And the really good ones, when they're established, they know how to push off at the end of a route, too.
Mahomes now on first down. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Mahomes going to throw. The tight end Kelsey has it over the middle. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on 2nd down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on 3rd down.
An extra corner comes on now for the Patriots D on 3rd down.
Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it.
On Edwards-Helaire, I don't think he got there. He did not. They'll stop him short. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a 4th down.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Here's the Chiefs punter now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. Fair catch signaled for and taken just shy of the 30-yard line. 37 yards on the punt with no return, and the Patriots take over. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
The drive starts with a carry by Stevenson.
And this will go for 5 up to the 33.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a 1st down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
Second and five now. Jones, and this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides, and there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. Back to throw, Jones. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
The Patriots send out their punter as he's on here to punt it away. Hardman on the return. 13 yards, the tally on the return there. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Tyreek Hill making his way back out towards the huddle. And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Now how about this throw right here? Had to throw it to the left sideline, and you know the timing's got to be correct on this one. Ball's got to be right where it needs to be, and it was. That's because he had great arm strength on that one, able to drive the football. Quarterbacks love it when they can show off their arms.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Edwards-Helaire as they run out of the gun. And he stopped immediately there. Juwan Bentley there to get him down. They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL, and he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time, so make sure you get in shape.
Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. The Chiefs on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This will be 3rd and 6. Now Mahomes. Forced out to his left. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's 4th.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Here's the Chiefs punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time.
And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Off the play fake, Jones. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well, incomplete.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Throwing again, Jones. Open man is born. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
New England on third down, 5 out of 9 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. Off the bootleg, Jones. This one to Bourne, and he's got it. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark, because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
Oh, so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here, down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Stevenson now on first and 10. And he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it, but what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
Just a yard of the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3. He was close to flirting with that sideline, but able to stay in bounds like you know his coach wants him to do and keep that clock moving.
Isn't it funny that we're watching this play when we had that discussion just yesterday about this? What do you do in this scenario? What do you, you know, what's your mindset? It appeared to me that he'd totally forgotten that he needed to stay in bounds, and then the last second, oh no, I better get down. And he ended up doing the right thing. But at that point, maybe close to letting it slip away. That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
Now Jones on first down. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions, they are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. On the give, this is Harris. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. How about about this offensive line? They're really starting to establish themselves, take over this game.
And before the series began, I know exactly what was said in the defensive huddle. Guys, we got to get no less than a three and out. Let's get off the field. Instead, they can't find any traction towards doing that. Right now, they're just getting muscled all over the field and getting pushed down it.
They'll run on first down. It's Harris. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw.
He'll dump this down to Stevenson.
It'll be a gain of 5, and just like that, it's third down.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss. And they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. Here's Jones on third down. That is caught inside the 5. Touchdown!
Jones finding Nelson Agholor for the touchdown there.
And the Patriots add 6 to their lead. They have to love seeing that from their young quarterback here in the fourth quarter, able to further that lead with a touchdown pass.
He didn't go turtle, did he? And you know what I mean by that. I had an old coach used to say all the time, hey, when we have a lead late, don't just tuck in and try and ride it out. Go out and play and extend the lead. And that's what he did.
Now Folk for the extra point. It's good, and it's 21-10. That one in the books as a 12-play drive, and it ends with a New England touchdown. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown.
Fielded just outside the goal line.
Now a hit and a loose football. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line.
So problems compounding themselves here on the return. They just give up the touchdown, and now they lose the football.
Yeah, partner, things are starting to unravel a little bit for them right in front of our eyes. They're going to be looking for some answers, and quickly.
Jones now on first and 10. It's caught on the right side at Smith. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22.
Another nice pickup through the air. And I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon. But with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Here's second and 5 now from the 22.
They run with Harris, and he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher third down looming.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there, and now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Thank you. Jones to throw on third down. Throwing middle, and it's complete.
And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
But when you're up by two scores in the fourth quarter and you're going to throw the football, expect to see a lot of man coverage, because usually what comes along with man coverage is pressure. So if you're a play caller and you want to keep throwing the football, that's fine. Just make sure your offensive line understands they're going to get additional guys running at the quarterback.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10.
Here's Harris, and a pickup of about four down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
Well, no doubt here in the fourth quarter, this is a huge defensive series.
Hey, they can read the scoreboard. They realize if they give up a field goal here, this game might be out of reach. They understand the stakes and are playing accordingly.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six.
They run again with Harris. And he'll take this from the 9 down to about the 7.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the Trash Man. His ability to sip through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker.
Looking to throw. Jones. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
The frustration evident there, because he couldn't find anyone on third down, and he left no doubt that he was throwing that one away.
The Patriots will bring on the field goal unit. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And Fultz's kick is good. And that will get the lead up to 14.
So that maybe not a knockout blow, but I suppose certainly every little bit helps when you're trying to salt one away in the fourth.
Well, the possibility of being beaten by two late touchdowns or at least sent to overtime does exist, but time, definitely a big factor at this stage of the game, is in their favor.
Now after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away.
And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks, because then the defense has the advantage.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up 1st and 10 at their own 22. They'll try and start this drive in the air. That's complete to Robinson. They'll contain him to just 4, 2nd down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball, because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Throwing again on 2nd down. Mahomes, it's Kelce on the ground. Fourth quarter, every drive's so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the 2nd touchdown. You can have the 1st one for the 2nd one to even matter.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. Mahomes now to throw.
That to his running back, Edwards-Helaire.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
Now it's Mahomes again. And that's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. Gets this one to Hill. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. He's got his man. That's Hardman. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Mahomes to throw it. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. He was unable to shake free there, and they'll cover him for a loss of a yard. And Mahomes going to hustle him up to the line here. Mahomes will throw. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. A long way to go here on third down for the eighth play of the drive. Here's Mahomes. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down. This home crowd, they're happy with that call.
I like the way you said happy there, right? The so-called good guys didn't get a call. They feel like it's been that way all afternoon. You feeling their pain?
They finally got one.
Yes, they did.
Mahomes to the right side. It's Kelce. A gain of 6 there on first.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. The Chiefs will try and get to the line quickly. Mahomes to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
And now the focus is really clear. They need to get that first down and either get out of bounds or maybe use one of those timeouts.
Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. Mahomes. And this is caught for a touchdown. So hang on now. Things just got a little bit more interesting here in the final minute.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope.
And now remember, all touchdowns are reviewed, and in a tight game like this, they're going to take a good long look at it. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds. That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
After reviewing the play,
so they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Butker now to add the extra point. He's got it, and it's 24-17. A pretty long drive that time, 11 plays all told. And it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt. So still a chance with just over 20 seconds to go, but they need to get this one back, no doubt. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
First down carry for Harris. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds remaining. The first down run got five. Here's second and five. They'll keep it on the ground. Harris again. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they stop it with 14 seconds to go in the game. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Third down, here's Harris, finding room to the 20, and all the way down to the 17-yard line. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. Down to a knee goes Jones, and that should just about seal it. So this will wind up a victory for the New England Patriots. And I'll tell you what, it has not been with a whole lot of frequency over the last couple of decades or so that teams have come into New England and escaped with a victory, but that's what happened here.
It almost doesn't feel real, does it?
We've seen it so few times.
That actually happened, right? We saw it. They came out of there with a win. And on the other side, in that locker room, you know what they're saying? we didn't really lose. Time just ran out on us. That's the attitude they have because they don't see it happen very often, not even sure how to handle it.
And you see some stunned faces heading for the exits here in New England. Just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. From Kansas City, so long, everybody.